Today, from Ford Field in Detroit, it's the NFC Wild Card Round on EA Sports. As we'll see Lamar Jackson and the Detroit Lions taking on Brock Purdy and the Minnesota Vikings.
This Lion fan base have been craving home playoff football since this building opened in 2002, and they've got it today at Ford Field in Detroit. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the postseason on EA Sports. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And, Charles, that's really all I need to say to get you fired up. It's the postseason on EA Sports.
And no one's more fired up than the guys who are going to be playing in this game. This is what they fought for all year long. Go back to the OTAs, the mini camps, training camp, throughout the season to get to the playoffs. The intensity level will be off the charts.
So here's the Viking offense making their way out. And they'll be led out by their quarterback now in his third season in the league.
And you'd think as a young QB, there'd be some nerves leading an offense out to start a game, but haven't seen any sign of them right now. And speaking with him earlier this week, sensed that the pressure wouldn't get to him. He feels comfortable being the face of this offense and shouldering the expectations on game day, even if he doesn't quite have the years of experience other quarterbacks do.
First play, and Purdy wants to throw it. Man open, that's Ja'Marr Chase, complete. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. First catch of this wild card game for a 1,000-yard receiver in the regular season. He's got a first down, too.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. First rep of the game for Josh Jacobs. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
A second down throw for Purdy. That's caught. It's Sam Laporta. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 41-yard line. Jacobs going to try the middle. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
You've got to be impressed by that defensive front on reps like those. They were not being moved off the line, kept their shoulders square, and gave their teammates time to fight to the ball and limit that gain.
Second down, Jacobs once more. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. First down marker at the 31. It's third down. Purdy. He's got his target. That's complete. And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Solid opening drive so far, Charles. They've moved this football into field goal range, but you know that they want to cap this off with 6 and not 3.
Absolutely. As one of the better coaches in the league always tells me, on offense, I want to throw body blows all game long and finish it with uppercuts. Well, here are the body blows right now. He's hoping in one uppercut we'll take care of the end of this drive.
Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script, you go through your play calling, you go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. They'll fake the jet sweep there. Instead, hand to Jacobs up the middle. They'll get forward for three down to the 16-yard line. Second and 7. Now Purdy. And that one off the mark behind him, incomplete.
Been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. His second catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a first down.
That's a big conversion there on third down, and this has been a great opening drive. You know, at this point, they'd hate to settle for 3, but they've created a fresh set of downs and a first and goal.
Jacobs is in. Touchdown, Minnesota. And that caps off what was really a balanced opening drive for them, Charles. They work in the rushing game and the aerial attack, and they end it with a touchdown.
Strong.
Oh, this is blocked. Now it's scooped up, and this is a live football. But he will not be able to bring this one back, and the extra point attempt unsuccessful.
But there's a blocked extra point. I remember playing in... We had one of those go against us. I remember our kicker and our holder told the head coach, just relax, coach. Why are you yelling? Don't worry about it. It's just 1 point. Oh, my. Those coaches see a point is gold to them because you never know how it's going to turn out later.
Exactly. That's why I was just going to say first quarter. We'll see if this has any implications as the game goes on.
I still can't believe they told the head coach to relax. Whoa.
Bad move. So here are the Lions now coming out for their opening drive. They'll be led out by the final pick of the first round in 2018 out of Louisville. It's Lamar Jackson.
And he remains the league's premier rushing threat and one of the biggest playmakers among quarterbacks. His goal each and every season, continue to expand his game as a passer and become well-rounded. All those highlight reel plays you see, they come off the fact that he can run it, throw it, and scares defenses every time he takes a snap.
Jackson on first down, steps away to his left. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
I am willing to bet that he got a monster grin on his face when he saw what was happening. Man covers were so committed to denying a big throw that it pulled attention away from him, and he had an easy lane to hit, and hit it he did.
Oh, what a catch here by Kittle. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. First catch of this wild card game for a 1,000-yard receiver in the regular season. He's got a first down, too.
Love when the playbook comes to life and the execution is there. Man coverage on the outside. And if you like the matchup and you feel like your receiver can get the position he needs, you just throw it up there and let him do his thing. We see this a lot now with back shoulder routes and things like that. And this is a nice job to go up and get it. And they pick up a first down.
Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support. And I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. Lamar Jackson taking it in from 24 yards out. And the Lions are an extra point away from taking the lead.
This is a great decision right here. Out of the pocket to his left. And he knows if he waits too long, the defense is going to be all over him. So he makes a decision to go and wins the race to the pylon.
Elliott Good on the extra point. And they take the lead here at 7-6. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This one fielded in the end zone. He'll opt not to bring it out. A touchback, and they'll begin at the 30-yard line. Minnesota's offense takes over possession. They'll begin on the ground with Jacobs, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
He did have the touchdown run earlier, but not a heck of a lot more than that throughout this game.
No, not at all. In fact, I would say that this defense has done as good of a job on him as they have on any runner in recent memory.
Here's Purdy.
And the Lions pressure too strong. Down he goes. Miles Garrett just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. And he is going to go down. He will be sacked on the final play of this first quarter. After one, a 1-point game, 7-6. The Vikings with the football here to begin the second quarter, as they've got it with a 4th down coming up. Kamara now to return. A very nice punt that time, but they get 11 back on the return. And the Lions will take over. Back onto the field come the Lions for their 2nd overall drive. So good starting field position for them here as they come up 1st and 10 at their 36-yard line. Oh, look at that. What a catch by Moore. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. First catch of this wild card game for a 1,000-yard receiver in the regular season. He's got a 1st down, too. Jackson out to his left. Shrugs the tackle.
Nice.
And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be 2nd down.
Well, we've seen Jackson already have success in the first half running the football, and he gets good yardage on the ground again there. I mean, how? I know it's a $64,000 question, CD, but how do they contain him better?
You have to win against the blockers ahead of you. If those guys even occupy a defender for even a half a second, then Lamar Jackson is gone. You've got to take those blockers and move them so that you have clear vision of Lamar Jackson, and hopefully you can hem him in.
And he fends him off. He'll buy some time right. But he can't get away forever, and down he goes.
Multiple players combined for their team's 1st sack of the game. Here's 2nd and 10.
Now it's Jackson. This throw incomplete, nearly picked off.
And with his pedigree, he doesn't drop many of those. But 3rd down coming up.
Play action. Now Jackson. A high throw there as this is knocked away. Down to the ground and incomplete. Now Jake Elliott for the field goal try. From the right hash, this from an even 40 yards out. And that is no good. And this is going to remain a 1-point game.
Wow, that qualifies as a bad miss, because anything inside of 40 should be automatic. That's a big mistake right there.
So 1st and 10 now from the 30. On the ground, it's Jacobs to start the drive. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5.
Not a huge play, but I think they're more than happy with how it turned out. Don't be surprised to see them revisit that call, because there was a lane there for more than just 5 yards. Put it in your back pocket and break it out when you need it later.
Purdy's throw taken in here by Chase.
His 2nd catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a 1st down.
throwing here. Purdy. A little short pass here taken in by LaPorta.
And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2.
And Brandon, as you know, sometimes it's a lot tougher to run with these tight ends nowadays in the NFL. They're just bigger wide receivers. He lined up on the left side of the formation, ran a drag route across the field, and tried to work his way open. He was able to make the catch, but the defenders were there, couldn't do a whole lot with it afterwards.
On the Jets sweep, here's Chase.
And he is across midfield from 149 to the other 49, a gain of just 2.
But defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, and one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
The Vikings on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. They're looking at third and a few inches. Trying to run for it with Jacobs.
And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line.
2 minutes to play here in this first half of the NFL playoffs.
Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play.
Purdy to throw it on first down.
And under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down.
Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. And now a throw here secured by his running back out of the backfield.
They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down.
Purdy now to throw.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
And this ball recovered by the offense, but remember, they cannot advance it here in the final 2 minutes of the half. So this will be blown dead, and it'll come back to the spot of the fumble. Here's Tommy Townsend on to punt.
And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin him back.
And the Lions going to go back on offense one final time in this first half. And with a 1-point lead, you'd have to think they'll be looking just to get this to halftime. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield.
And a penalty flag comes in as that one winds up incomplete. But the contact is going to move the ball well downfield.
So a costly penalty yardage-wise as that'll move the football down to the spot of the foul.
And what the officials are looking for in these situations, whether you're playing the man or the ball. And if you're playing the man, you get a lot less leeway in terms of what's going to happen at the end of the play. But if you're looking for the football, it's less likely to draw the flag.
Meanwhile, Jackson's throw pulled in by Kittle.
The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Jackson now. Forced out to his left. And bulldozing his way through.
And the Lions are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the one. Chubb will take this one in. It's a Lions touchdown. Well, nothing fancy there, Charles. You had 3 tight ends on the field. They were going to run the football. The defense knew it, but the defense couldn't stop them.
And I haven't met an offensive line yet that doesn't get more satisfaction out of running the football into the end zone than pass protecting. They had determination on their side, and they got it done.
Elliott on for the extra point. And it's up. It's good. Our score, 14-6. So they only needed 3 plays on that drive. And Nick Chubb, the one to finish it off, as he does so with a touchdown run.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
And this return going to come to a quick end as he is belted at the end of that one. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And with 7 seconds remaining, not much time to really do anything.
A good running there by Jacobs on first down as he's able to take this forward for a gain of 6.
So we come upon halftime here in this NFC wild card matchup as we'll head down to Orlando. That's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports halftime report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. This game 2 of our triple header here on Wild Card Sunday. We'll get back out to you 2 in just a moment. We'll begin up at Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Where was
Well, look around the NFL. We'll have to wait for postgame because we are moving right through halftime and on to the third quarter. One of these two teams about to play their final half of the season as we're back at it in this NFC wildcard bout. And he will not bring it out. It's a touchback. The Lions offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number 3. And they've got the lead, CD. What do you expect from them in this second half?
Well, I like what they were able to do on the ground in the first half because they had a lot of success running the ball, and I certainly think we'll see more of that. But I'd keep an eye on that defense, and I think their coaches up in the box will do the exact same thing. If they start to see one or two guys start to creep towards the line of scrimmage, that'll be licensed to take some shots downfield.
So they will wave off the flag and let the completion stand.
Really great job by the receiver fighting through all the contact and still coming down with the football. All that great work and practice being put into the game.
And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
I really enjoy watching Lamar Jackson run those RPOs, Charles, but I'll tell you what, it's tough calling play-by-play because you don't know whether he handed it off or kept it.
Makes you focus, doesn't he? You've got to try and stay with it, and even when we do, we often can get it wrong because our eyes naturally go to him because he creates big plays. But if you're a runner and you're playing with Lamar Jackson, aren't you happy? He creates so much concentration on him, it should open up things for you.
And, oh, he's unable to hold on to that defensively. A potential game changer, but it falls incomplete.
I know in every game we do, we talk about momentum. That was a momentum play lost. And now there could be a letdown because they didn't get the interception.
Yeah, you could almost hear the collective gasp on the sideline as he could not come up with that football. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They'll run with Chubb. And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the 2.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown,
you want two.
You're without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
They'll give it to Chubb. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. Nick Chubb, his second touchdown of the afternoon.
And the Lions take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead.
Elliott Good with a PAT, and the lead is up to 15 now. So that one, an 8-play drive, it spans 75 yards. And Nick Chubb, the one to finish it off, as he does so with a touchdown run. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And no thought of bringing this one out. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll begin the drive at the 30. It's the Vikings' turn on offense. We get ready for their first possession of the second half.
And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go 3 and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially. But you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
On first down, it's Purdy. A little short pass here taken in by Laporta. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. Here's second and 7 now from the 28. Purdy off the play fake. Open man downfield is Davis. And out across midfield down to the 45. 27 yards there, a first down.
And that's the kind of play this offense needs to maybe kick them into gear a little bit. They've been stuck in neutral much of the game. Perhaps that can give them a little bit of confidence that big plays are out there.
But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. Now a give to Jacobs running right. Solid running on the carry, but still brought down just inside of the 40. 53 yards rushing for him now in the ball game. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They'll stay on the ground with Jacobs. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough.
A lot depend on the spot there, and he got it, but it wasn't by much, was it? I remember Coach Madden talking about, depending on which foot the official used, that would tell you whether you had the first down or not. You want that upfield foot to be the one that spots the ball, don't you?
And you and I have the luxury of a couple extra views here in the booth, and he did get it, but not by much. So the completion gets him just a yard, and it'll be second down.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver, that makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
And that one to the right side and incomplete.
We've got to give out a little applause on that play. It has to go to the defense. More good work by them. They've taken away the passing lanes all game long, and you can see the frustration that it's causing because he just about threw that one into the first row.
Williams brings it in. And it's going to be another first down as he'll get him to the ground at the Lions 23. It's a gain of 11 as the Vikings pick up the first. Here's Jacobs on first and 10. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
Second down, Jacobs once more. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. It's a 10-yard gain there to set him up first and goal.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
Purdy will set up to throw it here. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Gabriel Davis, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Vikings are able to get a score back in the final stages of this third quarter. This time, the extra point up and good. And that'll cut the lead to 21-17. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. And the returner down to a knee, and this will come out to the 30-yard line. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. And Jackson cannot get away, and he'll go down. It's J.O.K., Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah, in there for the sack. One quarter remains in this NFC wild card matchup. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Play action. It's Jackson. That's down the field for Jefferson. Launches deep. A jump ball, and this is caught. A big play there for Detroit. 48 yards.
And that was another Justin Jefferson special. Went up over the top of the defender and snagged it. He may look like he's covered, but he finds a way to uncover at the end of plays. 6'1" listed, plays like he's 6'5", and jumps like he's 10 feet tall.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. They go play action with Jackson. Now a leaping catch, he's got it. And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10. His second catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a first down.
And these guys,
Kevin O'Connell, clearly unhappy with that call, and he's thrown that red challenge flag out on the field. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call. Winds up a very good call there defensively to challenge that one, as that now will wind up an incomplete pass. And they will stop him short. They get him to the ground at the 27, no first down. It'll be a gain of 4, but it won't be enough. It leaves them with a 4th down now. So the field goal unit is on the field, as this is a big spot right here. This to make it a 2-score game. The kick by Elliott is good. And that will extend their lead even further. So that's, CD, an important one here in the 4th quarter.
And that importance cannot be overstated. All eyes on both sidelines were staring that one down all the way. The significance is that they made it a 2-score game. Still lots of time left to go, but likely that was their goal at the start of the drive. Get 3 points, make it a 2-score game, and they were able to get it done.
And now out comes Minnesota. If they want to advance in this divisional round, look, obviously the time is now. Trailing here in the 4th as they go to work on a crucial, crucial drive, 1st and 10. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe 3. Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. Purdy from the gun. Open man downfield is Chase. He's got it. He's to the 15. Touchdown, Vikings. Jamar Chase, 72 yards. And the Vikings have made it a 1-score game again here in the 4th. So that's a really big play here in the 4th quarter. And don't look now, they're right back in this game.
Did it feel to you as it did to me that maybe they were a little bit soft in what they were lining up with on defense? Almost like they were protecting the lead rather than trying to make a play.
And now that lead is down to just 1 score. Well, I guess the coach looked at the 2-point cheat sheet, said go for it, get it to a 3-point game, and they did it.
Yeah, and sometimes you just throw out time of game. You don't worry about that. There's just a feel sometimes in making that call, and he felt good about what he had for a 2-point conversion, and now they're only down 3 and feeling great about themselves.
So the Lions offense ready to go back out onto the field. And this a very important drive leading in the 4th quarter of this wild card game. But this one far from over as they start out here 1st down. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. So pass interference, the call there. Always, obviously, Charles, such a subjective call. You agree with the penalty?
Well, from where we're standing right now, I think the officials are tightening things up here in the second half. Maybe a defender gets away with that in the first, but this time the flag comes out, and I think it's a good call.
They go play action now. Jackson, that is incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Stopped short of the 25. The second effort couldn't free him. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
And this is the worry, because sometimes you can get a little too predictable in spots like this. You know you're going to run the ball, but they know you're going to run the ball as well. And now you look up, and you're staring at an important third down.
That is caught, and he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. His second catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a first down. Big hook up there, forced to throw it on third down. The connection's going to keep the drive alive and also keep the clock moving.
Yeah, and from a defensive perspective, didn't get a sack, didn't knock the ball free, didn't break up the pass. The clock keeps running on you. You're in a dire situation now.
They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. They'll try again with Chubb. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3. Three points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So the Lions in possession of the football as we welcome you back. They've got it third and goal now as they look for that final touchdown to salt this one away. They run it again with Chubb, and he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to swell the lead to 6. The kick by Elliott is good. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in 3.
So that gets him a little bit of breathing room, but not much. And you have to think back to the field goal that he missed earlier. This would be a 2-score game right now if he had converted then.
And if you and I are thinking about it, you know he is as well, because in the back of his mind, he's thinking, I hope I get one more shot in an important spot. He just made that one. He wants one more later to truly make up for the earlier miss.
So all eyes on this Vikings offense. Down 27-21. A minute 53 remaining. It's got to be a touchdown here, and that won't be easy. On the road, in the playoffs, as they've got it with a first down. Able to connect with Jacobs. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7. Past the 30 to the 32. Purdy to throw. And that's caught by Williams. Here's Purdy. And that is caught. It's Davis. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done.
Plenty of time and 2 timeouts still at their disposal. First and 10 here.
This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2.
Here's Purdy to throw. He'll swing that out wide to Jacobs. And he is going to get out of bounds with the first down. So that's going to double their pleasure for sure. They get the first and save a timeout. Throwing, Purdy. Over the middle and taken in by Laporta.
And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. Now another timeout called for by the offense, as he'll stop it with 27 seconds showing on the clock.
Here's second down. To throw is Purdy.
Got his man complete over the middle. That's Davis.
This is first and 10.
The Vikings going to use their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break.
No timeouts left. Of course, the defense knows that too. Here's first and 10.
Purdy to throw. This to LaPorta, right side.
The Lions stay alive as we say thanks for watching and so long.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. It's a win for the Lions as we say so long.